What's going on, everybody? Andy here. I'm going to show you how to turn on, set up the Med4 ice compression system that we use now here at the Swamp Fox Performance Lab. Now, as I walk up to the device, you'll notice that it's got a blank screen there and the light is amber. That means the power supply is turned on from the back to the wall to the power supply along the wall, however you want to word that, but it's getting juice, right? And the idea is to be able to turn it on without creating some kind of weirdness. Here, I press the amber button. It's a touch screen. Notice how it just turned green. You can hear the hum. And now it is booting up. It's going to take it a couple of minutes to get fully up and going. So what you're noticing here is that the boot screen is just kicking on right now. You'll see that it's loading. That means it's going through its pre-service check. Go through, shouldn't take this too much longer than this. We like that sound, okay? That's a good sound. Any other sound you might want to be worried about? Oh, there it goes, starting to hum up a little bit more. And now what it's doing is testing the water that's inside the tank already. There are two tanks. There's a heating tank and a cooling tank. And right now what it's doing is checking those temperatures to make sure that they are at the set temperature that we had it at last time, okay? This is the active, let me make sure it's still on. This is what it's currently reading. This is what it's currently reading. This is what it's currently set at. This is what it's currently set at. So by default, it should always be automatically set to 113 for heat and 38 degrees Fahrenheit, since we're Americans, for cool. Notice it can go up, like I can raise the cool temperature, but at 38 is as low as it goes. Vice versa, we could bring the heat down and we crank it up. You'll notice that there is a 1 to 2 person, and that correlates to the hose connector, right? So on the left side is a 1, on the right side is a 2. You'll notice that they're hung, definitely, with the dongle face up. That's so that any of the residual water that's within the hose does not leak out. All right, we're going to go through the setup and demonstration real quick. Since I've already set up the compression system on my back, I also have made the connection to the dongle, or from the dongle to the Med4. What I'm going to do now is walk through the system of setting it up, okay? So here, back out of it, this is the main screen that you should see. From there, you'll notice that it's already preset for the hottest. So you'll go down and come back up. And the coldest settings, that's there. So what we'll want to do is, now that I've set up to the first apparatus or first side, the 1, we're going to press 1. We'll select cold therapy because this is blue, not red. We'll hit this, and we can adjust the time. We're going to start with the time. It's no lower than 5 minutes, so whenever you start this device, you're going to have to commit yourself to 5 minutes. But for guys that are severely traumatized or have a lot more inflammation to kind of work out, or if you just happen to have a lot more adiposity, meaning you're fatter, then we're going to crank it up a little bit, and we'll adjust that as time goes by. But for here, in the demonstration purposes, I'm going to set for 5 minutes. Next, I want to select the compression level. So right now it's set for max. And then we got light, obviously. You can have whatever suits your bill there. And then we'll turn it down. You'll notice where it's got the little circle and the slash. It means it's off. Okay. So let's cut it up some so I can feel it. Hit the play button. And now my 5 minutes has begun. Okay. Okay, everybody. I got the compression system on and going right now. Right now I want to just kind of turn myself so you can see the bulge in the back. That means that it's pumping itself full of fluid. And the compression system is working to basically pump more fluid into it and withdraw less. It'll kind of go through its different stages, however it's programmed to do that. And so right now what I'm experiencing most of is the cool sensation across my lower back. Right. So a couple of things you really want to pay attention to is if it's too tight, obviously you got to make an adjustment. That's easy enough to kind of adjust the belt. Another thing is making sure that you're not stepping on the hose. It's a pretty big, you know, ordeal. Normally I would just have you lay down on the table, but in self-preservation times, let's kind of assume the worst here. And again, you know, it is pumping itself full of fluid and not air, okay? So as it's doing so, that means it's gonna have a residual amount of water retained into the bladder itself, even after it's done making its compressions or after it's done completing its cryotherapies. Then you want to be mindful that it is still with the dongle upright. So you can kind of see where the cool met my lower back heat. Okay, sweated a little bit, it's cool. But also you want to make sure you kind of push a little bit of extra into there so that it drains out the bladder. Because when you disconnect it, remember the little blue button, there'll sometimes be a little residual water hanging around here. And that's also why these hoses hook. Action camera! Hook upright like so.